In the next part, we will discuss Credit 1 Sustainable Building Materials and Credit 4 Use of Certified Green Building Materials, Products and Equipment. They both are associated with sustainable building materials. The intent or objective of both the credits is to encourage the use of sustainable building materials and thereby reduce the environmental impact associated with extracting, manufacturing and transporting building materials. The strategies to incorporate sustainable building materials can be broadly classified into three areas. Number one, reduce the demand for new buildings. That is, reuse existing buildings by renovating and refurbishing existing buildings, extend the life of existing buildings, thereby reduce the demand for new buildings. Number two, reduce the demand for new materials by reusing salvaged and refurbished materials. And finally, if new materials are to be procured, procure sustainable building materials. Sustainable building materials include materials manufactured with recycled content, materials manufactured locally, rapidly renewable materials, certified wood, and certified products. We will discuss each of the sustainable materials in detail in the coming slides. Let us start with the first strategy, building reuse. Retain or reuse existing structural and non-structural components of the building. Structural components include beams, columns, floor, slabs, load-bearing walls, structural glazing, and any other structural component of the building. Non-structural components include flooring, ceiling, interior walls, doors, etc. It is not recommended to reuse hazardous, contaminated and damaged parts of the building. MEP equipments are also not recommended to be reused. Generally, older MEP equipments are inefficient. Points are awarded based on percentage of surface area retained or reused in existing building. The next strategy is to reduce the demand for new materials by using salvaged or refurbished materials instead of new materials. By using salvaged or refurbished materials, we are reducing the demand for virgin materials and other natural resources. Common salvaged materials that can be reused are furniture, doors, cabinets, bricks, tiles, etc. Points are awarded based on percentage of building's material cost spent on salvaged or refurbished materials. Building's material cost include civil and interior building materials and does not include equipments. It also does not include labor and installation cost. The next strategy is to use materials manufactured with recycled content. Recycled content can be of two types, post-consumer recycled content and pre-consumer recycled content. Post-consumer recycled materials are materials which are consumed and sent for recycling. Examples for post-consumer recycled materials include used newspapers, milk gallons, construction waste, etc. Pre-consumer recycled materials are materials which are not being consumed but it is considered to be waste. Examples for pre-consumer recycled materials include unsold newspapers, industrial waste like sawdust, fly ash, etc. Remember that this credit is about using materials manufactured with recycled content and it is not about recycling itself. Materials with recycled content that are certified by GreenPro or other third parties approved by IGBC can be used to demonstrate compliance for this credit. Similar to previous credit, points are awarded based on percentage of cost of materials spent on materials with recycled content. The next strategy is to use materials manufactured locally. Locally here means within 400 kilometers radius from the project site. A point to note here is that only materials manufactured within 400 kilometers from project site will be considered for the credit, and materials locally assembled will not be considered for the credit. There are two benefits associated with using local materials. Number one, using local materials reduces the environmental impact associated with transportation of the materials. And number two, using local materials promote circular economy and improve the standard of living of the local people. Again, similar to the previous two credits, points are awarded based on the amount of money spent on local materials. The next strategy is to use rapidly renewable materials. Rapidly renewable materials are materials that can be harvested or regenerated very fast, that is within 10 years. Rapidly renewable materials are generally from agricultural products. Examples of rapidly renewable materials include bamboo-based materials, linoleum, wheat board, straw board, cork, etc. Use of rapidly renewable materials reduces the demand for virgin natural resources. Certified wood is harvested from forests which are managed by environmentally and socially responsible forest management principles. Certified wood products from FSC, that is Forest Steward Council, or Program of the Endorsement of Forest Certification, or any other equivalent programs are eligible to comply with this credit requirement. Similar to the previous requirements, points are awarded based on the amount of money spent on rapidly renewable or certified wood products. The next strategy is to use certified green products. Certified green products will help the consumers to choose the right material, products, equipment and technologies, and thereby reduce the environmental impact associated with construction, operation and maintenance of their projects. IGBC encourages the use of certified products from GreenPro or any other equivalent third parties approved by IGBC. Points are allotted based on the number of certified products used in the project. Thanks for your attention. If you have any questions, please ask them in the forum.